Welcome to the Utah High School Activities Association's presentation of the 2017 State 3A Soccer Championship on the NFHS network. We're looking forward to a great match today, folks. The Juan Diego Catholic Soaring Eagles playing against the Ridgeline High School Riverhawks. Should be a great matchup. Ridgeline has one loss on the season. That's to, you guessed it, Juan Diego. Ridgeline has a great striker in J.C. Vasquez. Coincidentally, the head coach for Ridgeline is J.C. Vasquez. Also, Juan Diego's Soaring Eagles number 10, Ruben Castillo, is the forward. He's leads the state right now with goals on the season, and that's across all classifications. So should be a great match. Looking forward to some great soccer. We're going to go to some words from our sponsors.
This event is brought to you by Olive Garden. Olive Garden is proud to be the official dining room of high school sports. With menu choices to please the entire family, as well as to-go and catering options, it's the perfect restaurant for your post-game dining. To find your nearest location or to order your meal online, visit olivegarden.com. This game is brought to you by Under Armour, maker of the world's best apparel, footwear, and accessories. Check out the full line of performance gear now at UA.com. Under Armour. I will.
Welcome back, excuse me, to the broadcast of the 2017 3A State Championship soccer match. These teams have worked their way through the brackets. Yesterday, the Juan Diego Catholics Soaring Eagles did score quite often as they beat the Logan Grizzlies 3-0. Also, the Ridgeline Riverhawks beat the Snow Canyon Warriors yesterday. So these two teams who have played each other twice this season, splitting results, will play now for the 3A state championship. We're about 8 minutes away from the beginning of the match, so we're going to go to some words from our sponsors. Thank you so much for joining us on the NFHS Network.
Shakespeare said that all the world's a stage, and men and women are merely players. But Mr. Shakespeare never met Stephen Curry.
Ni hao, the guy who's in the gym every dang day. Patriots say I'm the underdog, the league's most unguardable player.
Bang, he knocks it down.
So my apologies to Mr. Shakespeare, because onto the stage of mere players enters the babyface assassin. And he's about to write his own story.
Fall back.
You know, the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. But in our book, we say you are what you repeatedly do when things get hard. When you look at the naysayers and the haters, and there's a million of them, but you take it upon yourself to erase all doubt. Get that doubt out of here. So my apologies to Aristotle, but excellence doesn't become a habit by running the same path over and over. The excellent ones just step up to the line and ask, what's the record? Under Armour, get your feet straight.
I want to encourage others to play volleyball or choir because you get to experience new things and do stuff that you've never done before. My reason why is passion.
Not just selling me tires.
Thanks for running out to my car to greet me.
Like, running.
Thanks for checking my brakes for free.
For fixing my flat.
For free.
And being just hassle-free.
For talking to me like an intelligent human being.
You don't see that too often.
Thanks for hustling to get me out of there.
Without making me feel hustled.
So thanks.
Thanks.
Thanks for doing the right thing by not just selling me tires.
Les Schwab Tires. Doing the right thing matters.
Take two, Mark?
I guess.
I go like this.
The best part about playing football in Texas has to be the reaction from the community.
I want to encourage others to play volleyball or choir because you get to experience new things and do stuff that you've never done before. My reason why is passion.
My reason why is pride.
Coaches teach your kids to dream. Coaches teach your kids to overcome. Coaches teach your kids good sportsmanship. Coaches teach your kids proper technique. But who teaches your coaches?
National studies show that students who participate in activities like music, sports, and drama not only have better grades and attendance, but they develop the character to handle adversity, the grace to accept defeat, and the self-confidence to start over. Take part. Get set for life.
See ya, honey.
You wouldn't do this with your car. So why would you let it happen to your body? You've got too much to do to tolerate the aches and pains that could be treated easily and inexpensively. Registered physical therapists can get you back to work and play fast. In most cases, you don't need a doctor's referral, and treatment is covered by almost all insurance. Come in for a free consultation, and let's get you fully active again. Go to rptonline.com for more information. Easy to spot people who participated in high school sports and activities.
Right on time.
They learned important lessons like leadership, teamwork, respect.
Hey, our meeting moved to 10.
We'll be ready.
Values that last a lifetime.
We need to focus on three factors.
Support high school sports and activities in your community. When kids take part, they get set for life. Just a reminder, kids who participate in high school activities tend to go a little farther than those who don't. Take part. Get set for life.
Welcome back to the 2017 State Soccer 3A Championships on the NFHS Network. We're looking forward to a great match between the Juan Diego Catholic Soaring Eagles and the Ridgeline Riverhawks. Both these teams play in the same region, and they split their meetings with Ridgeline winning one, Juan Diego winning the other. So looking to break that tie and to win a state championship are both the Riverhawks and the Eagles. The NFHS Network would like to thank our corporate sponsors, Under Armour and Olive Garden, for their support to put your kids on the air. And a very special thanks goes to the Utah High School Activities Association and its member schools for their support of the National Federation of State High School Associations and the NFHS Network. Mentioned earlier, this game is going to be a game featuring two great strikers, J.C. Vasquez, who is the striker for the Riverhawks, has really got a nose for the goal. He was able to score yesterday and was in a lot of good opportunities. The head coach of the Riverhawks is also J.C. Vasquez. So there's obviously a relation there. And for the Juan Diego Soaring Eagles, their striker actually leads all classifications across the state of Utah, so 2A, 3A, 4A, and 5A in goals scored. That is number 10, Ruben Castillo, for the Juan Diego Soaring Eagles. We want to also let you know that you can use your mobile device to log on and watch your favorite high school sporting events wherever you are, whenever you want. Never miss another beat, and never miss another game. The NFHS Network school broadcast program makes it easy for students to produce live video broadcasts by providing the software, tools, and training they need for free. Now schools can produce and distribute high-quality events throughout the year, including regular season sports, graduation, band, cheer events, as well as other school activities. If your school is interested in becoming a part of the NFHS Network school broadcast program, please write to sbp@nfhsnetwork.com. That's sbp@nfhsnetwork.com. nfhsnetwork.com. We are high school. The officials and the teams enter the field. We're going to have introductions of rosters and the national anthem, but we're going to go to a commercial break for that, and we'll be back with the start of the 3A soccer championship. Thank you for joining us on the NFHS Network. We'll be right back.
Shakespeare said that all the world's a stage, and men and women are merely players. But Mr. Shakespeare never met Stephen Curry. Ni hao. The guy who's in the gym every dang day. Patriot Saint, I'm the underdog. The league's most unguardable player. Bang, he knocks it down. So my apologies to Mr. Shakespeare, because onto the stage of mere players enters the babyface assassin. And he's about to write his own story.
Fall back.
You know, the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. But in our book, we say you are what you repeatedly do when things get hard. When you look at the naysayers and the haters, and there's a million of them, but you take it upon yourself to erase all doubt. Get that doubt out of here. So my apologies to Aristotle, but excellence doesn't become a habit by running the same path over and over. The excellent ones just step up to the line and ask, what's the record? Under Armour, get your feet straight.
I want to encourage others to play volleyball or choir because you get to experience new things and do stuff that you've never done before. My reason why is passion.
Not just selling me tires.
Thanks for running out to my car to greet me.
Like, running.
Thanks for checking my brakes for free.
For fixing my flat
for free.
And being just hassle-free.
For talking to me like an intelligent human being.
You don't see that too often.
Thanks for hustling to get me out of there.
Without making me feel hustled.
So thanks.
Thanks. Thanks for doing the right thing by not just selling me tires.
Les Schwab Tires. Doing the right thing matters.
I go like this.
The best part about playing football in Texas has to be the reaction from the community.
I want to encourage others to play volleyball or choir because you get to experience new things and do stuff that you've never done before. My reason why is passion.
My reason why is pride.
Coaches teach your kids to dream. Coaches teach your kids to overcome. Coaches teach your kids good sportsmanship. Coaches teach your kids proper technique. But who teaches your coaches?
National studies show that students who participate in activities like music, sports, and drama not only have better grades and attendance, but they develop the character to handle adversity, the grace to accept defeat, and the self-confidence to start over. Take part. It's set for life.
See ya, honey.
You wouldn't do this with your car. So why would you let it happen to your body? You've got too much to do to tolerate the aches and pains that could be treated easily and inexpensively. Registered physical therapists can get you back to work and play fast. In most cases, you don't need a doctor's referral, and treatment is covered by almost all insurance. Come in for a free consultation, and let's get you fully active again. Go to rptonline.com for more information. People who participated in high school sports and activities.
Right on time.
They learned important lessons like leadership, teamwork, respect.
Hey, our meeting moved to 10.
We'll be ready.
Values that last a lifetime.
We need to focus on three factors.
Support high school sports and activities in your community. When kids take part, they get set for life. Just a reminder, kids who participate in high school activities tend to go a little farther than those who don't. Take part. Get set for life.
Welcome back to the Utah High School Activities Association's presentation of the 2017 State 3A Championships of Soccer on the NFHS Network. In the white is the designated home team, the Ridgeline Riverhawks. They finished first in their region, finishing second in that same region as Juan Diego Catholic Eagles. They're in the blue uniforms. Ridgeline will start with ball. We're underway. Ridgeline has possession early, headed to J.C. Vasquez. Crosses, and picked up by the keeper, Martin Kelly. Juan Diego has the ball, goes out of bounds off the Riverhawks. Ball's tossed in. I'm here on the near side. Aggressive tackle early. J.C. Vasquez puts on the afterburners. And it's Ridgeline's ball. The Ball's thrown in bounds to J.C. Vasquez. Crosses. Goes off number 14. Seth Blazingham. Still Riverhawks ball. Ball's tossed in. Shot on goal. Finally picked up by Martin Kelly, the goalkeeper. Intense sequence there. Ball's cleared the middle of the field, and Juan Diego possesses it. Taken now by Ridgeline. Chipped ahead to Vasquez. Juan Diego now on the offensive. But Joseph Enhaus, the senior keeper, is able to field it. Juan Diego still has possession. Cleared out. Juan Diego still with possession. There's a tackle there. That's a foul, and Juan Diego will have the free kick. Alex Saunders to send it away. That's headed out by the Eagles. So goal kick for Joseph Enhaus. The wind's down. Died down quite a bit. It was pretty windy earlier today with the two-way matchup, making for better conditions. Tackle in the box. Early in the match, there's no penalty, though, as the Juan Diego crowd is calling for it. It's the number one scorer in the state. Number 10, Ruben Castillo. Number 7, Christian Carabaja. With the shot on goal. J.C. Vasquez with the ball. Now in the open field, number 19, Jared Mariani. Shoots ahead, Joseph Enhaus is able to grab it though. Up ahead, J.C. Vasquez chasing it down. Near corner. Passes back. Ruben Castillo with the ball. Loses ball back to the Riverhawks. Ruben Castillo. Got a penalty, a little bit of shoving. It's on number 9, Mario Saldivar for the Riverhawks. Exciting opening minutes in this 3A final. Kick to come from Alex Saunders. Passes to Castillo. Chipped up ahead. But cleared. Castillo in the open field. That physical play early as Christian Finney gave something a little extra to Castillo or to Vasquez. I have to say, I'm guessing that he sold that a little bit, though. Martin Kelly sets everything up and sends it. Riverhawks have possession. Working the far side of the field. Out of bounds. Juan Diego to toss in. On the far side. Off of, I think that was number three, Houston Galter. Foul called. I think that was number eight, Gustavo Flores of the Eagles that earned that. Ruben Castillo stands in the way. Make sure his men are set. Sent in. Ridgeline's ball. Juan Diego sends it away. Cleared out by Ridgeline. Ruben Castillo now has the ball. Say it was out of bounds. Castillo had a lot of effort to try and save that ball, keep it in play, but goal kick coming from Joseph Venhaas. Deep kick. Wynn picks it up, and Juan Diego is going to have the ball on their attacking half of the field. Cleared away. Number three, Raimona Tinorari. Tino Rarari with the extra push. Gives the Riverhawks a free kick. JC Vasquez wins the ball. Foul called on Ruben Castillo. Ten minutes into the match. Lots of excitement so far. Castillo chips ahead. Ball's out of bounds. Clear it out, but ends up middle. Shot is high. Coming from JC Vasquez. A nice look. goal kick for Martin Kelly. Sub in, number 8, Gustavo Flores checks out. Number 5, Matthew Lillian checks in. Juan Diego with possession. Ridgeline has the ball. They're going to toss it in on the far side. Ball's up ahead. Cross to be sent. And it looks like we have a corner kick upcoming for Juan Diego. Scoring opportunity. I can't tell from here, but I think it's Jared Mariani that's going to be sending that kick in for the Soaring Eagles. Can't quite see the number. Here it comes. Headed out nicely. Shot coming from Castillo. Penalty called against Juan Diego. Big kick comes. Juan Diego wins it. One back by Ridgeline and they clear it out. See if there's an opportunity for a counter, as there's not, as Juan Diego again has possession in the attacking part of their field. Now Ridgeline with the ball, looking to make a counter. And they slow it down past center. JC Vasquez with the ball now. Kicked out of bounds. And number 7 for the Riverhawks comes to toss it in. Shot comes on goal from JC Vasquez. No score. Martin Kelly back to kick the ball free. Gets all of that one. And number 19 for the Eagles, Jared Mariani, had a shot on goal. A shot at the goal, went over top. Big kick from Joseph Venhaas. Headed by the Eagles. Still in play. Ball sent out. cleared out, but Juan Diego still has possession. Offside's called. Free kick coming. Number 24 for the Riverhawks, Sam Blad, sends it away. Juan Diego with the ball. Ball stolen away. Ridgeline working the near side. Nice touch pass. Juan Diego crowd does not like that call. But Ruben Castillo ran into number 11 for the Riverhawks, Reggie Anderson. Ball sent up. Ruben Castillo fighting for possession. He has it in the near corner. Centers it. It's cleared out. Centered. Again, cleared out. Juan Diego's had quite a few opportunities. Getting ready to throw the ball in now, looking for another. Juan Diego with possession, Mariani on the far side. Pass is out of bounds. That came off the foot of Kelton Zollinger. Again off Zollinger. Ball sent ahead. Martin Kelly. Excuse me. Martin Kelly gets the ball. Juan Diego wins possession. Ridgeline with the ball on the near side. Ooh, off the foot. Number 4, Benson Hill. Number 8 for Juan Diego, Gustavo Flores checks in. Number 13, DJ Benson checks in. And one other player for the Hawks that we missed. Foul called. Free kick for Juan Diego. kicked back to the keeper. Juan Diego with possession. Sent ahead. Ridgeline now with possession. Out of bounds. Out of bounds again. Off the foot of Matthew Lillian. Riverhawks toss it in. And it goes straight out of bounds. Juan Diego has the ball, toss it in. Oh. Correction. Ridgeline still has possession. They toss in. Pass was led a little much. Flores working up the field. Looking for Mariano. Ridgeline now with possession. Looking to attack. Centered. JC Vasquez shot. Far right. Martin Kelly. Goalkeeper gets ready for kick. Out for the Eagles is number 16, Saunders. In 25, Braden Reed. That ball sails out of bounds. Ridgeline has possession. Mariano. Booted away by number 11, Reggie Anderson. Sent high. Juan Diego with possession. Lillian attacking. Joseph Enhaus picks it up on the far side of his goalie box and boots it in midfield. Possession, or header won by Lillian. Possession goes to the Riverhawks. Up ahead is number 4. Juan Diego on this near side. Flores. Castillo now with the ball. Chips it in, back to Flores. Out of bounds, goal kick. Checking out for Ridgeline is number 4, Benson Hill. Checking in is number 12, Andy Payne. Payne's gonna get a hold of the ball right here. Flores, Lillian. Carlisle's number 11. He's upset. Number 12, Payne, tosses in to Vasquez, back to Payne. Vasquez. Header goes out of bounds. Carlisle will toss in. Number 16, Alex Saunders, checks in for the Eagles. Christian Carabaja checks out. Ball tossed in. Ball's out of bounds. Sent ahead to Vasquez. He's fighting for that position. Goal kick from Juan Diego's Martin Kelly. Pass up ahead to Vasquez, passes it back. Castillo with the ball. Out of bounds, off of Ridgeline. That's a bad call. Crowd knows it. Oh, foul's called. Flores. Lillian fighting for the ball. Castillo gets it. Mariano. Ball centered. Flores trying to get it. Nice move, though, coming from Mariano. A little bit of extracurricular shoving from Houston Golliter. Number 16, Alex Saunders, to send this ball in. Oh, just a little wide. Seth Blazing him almost had that at the corner. Could have sent that in. We're under 10 minutes to go here in the first half. It's really flown by. Checking out is Lillian. Also checking out is Ruben Castillo. Ball's grabbed by the keeper. Joseph Enhaz sends it midfield. Saved by number 11. And he's shoved down. That's a foul. Free kick coming from the corner. From that side of the field. Evan Carlisle with a lot of hustle on that play to win his team the free kick. Number 16, Alex Saunders, to kick this ball. Whistle blown. Here comes another shot from Saunders. Cleared out. Juan Diego still has possession. Shot comes. Two Tossed up to head to number 12, Andy Payne. Payne with the fresh legs. Wins the ball. Out of bounds. Vasquez tosses ahead. Payne gets the ball. Subs in. Number 4, Benson Hill. No, not quite. Juan Diego tosses the ball in. Out of bounds. Off Reggie Anderson. Evan Carlisle looks to toss the ball in. Anderson sends it away. Vasquez is found in the open field. Foul called. It's on number 9, Christian Finney. Sophomore defender from Juan Diego. Ball sent middle. Off the goalie. We'll have a corner kick on this near corner. Nice shot coming. JC Vasquez trotting over to the corner. He's going to send this corner kick in. Send back to Vasquez. Handball. Missed. Ball will be tossed in from this near corner. Vasquez to do it. Oh, passes that responsibility on. Number 7. We don't have this midfielder's name on the roster. Keeper falls on it. Nice opportunity. Juan Diego's ball there now on the offensive. Number 11, Evan Carlisle to toss the ball in. Robert Flores checks out. Not sure who checked in. Ball sent away. Penalty called. Against TJ Benson, I believe. He booted it out of bounds. And Juan Diego's crowd didn't like that. Then he was shoved a bit. And Ridgeline's crowd didn't like that. Now he's earned this penalty kick for the Eagles. Just over the top. Goal kick to come. hard ball to the face is taken as we stop the clock. 2:36 to go in the half. Not sure who he's subbing in for, but Kelton Zollinger comes in for the player that's hit with the ball. Juan Diego has the ball on the near side. Ball's kicked out of bounds. Ramiona Tenora Hardy had the ball there. Ball's kicked ahead. Ridgeline has an opportunity here. Cleared out. Vasquez with the ball. Number 9, Mario Saldivar. I think was maybe trying to send it, maybe trying to kick it towards the goal. Either way, it's much too high, and Martin Kelly, the keeper for the Eagles, will now send the ball to midfield. Juan Diego with the ball. Alex Saunders looking for Mariano. Ball's kicked. Too far. We have a minute to go here in the match. In the first half of the match. Ridgeline tosses the ball in. Out off Juan Diego. Ridgeline with the ball. Out of bounds. Juan Diego's ball. 30 seconds to go in the half. Looks like both teams are pretty content to go into half with this 0-0 score. We'll see if any explosions come. So Ridgeline kicks it ahead. That's the end of the half. 0-0 is the score. Both teams have had opportunities, though. I'm sure we'll see some scoring in the second half. Looking forward to some great second half soccer. We'll be right back on the NFHS Network. It's a broadcast of the Utah High School Activity Association's presentations of the 3A soccer final, Juan Diego versus Ridgeline, headed to half. We'll be back after a word from our sponsors.
William Shakespeare said that all the world's a stage, and men and women are merely players. But Mr. Shakespeare never met Stephen Curry. Nihao, the guy who was in the gym every dang day. Patron saint of the underdog, the league's most unguardable player.
Bang, he knocks it down.
So my apologies to Mr. Shakespeare, because onto the stage of mere players enters the babyface assassin. And he's about to write his own story.
Fall back.
You know, the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. But in our book, we say you are what you repeatedly do when things get hard. When you look at the naysayers and the haters, and there's a million of them, but you take it upon yourself to erase all doubt. Get that doubt out of here. So my apologies to Aristotle, but excellence doesn't become a habit by running the same path over and over. The excellent ones just step up to the line and ask, what's the record? Under Armour, get your feet straight.
I want to encourage others to play volleyball or choir because you get to experience new things and do stuff that you've never done before. My reason why is passion.
Not just selling me tires.
Thanks for running out to my car to greet me.
Like, running.
Thanks for checking my brakes for free.
For fixing my flat
for free.
And being just hassle-free.
For talking to me like an intelligent human being.
You don't see that too often.
Thanks for hustling to get me out of there.
Without making me feel hustled.
So thanks.
Thanks. Thanks for doing the right thing by not just selling me tires. Welcome.
Let's swap tires. Doing the right thing matters.
I go like this.
The best part about playing football in Texas has to be the reaction from the community.
I would encourage others to play volleyball or choir because you get to experience new things and do stuff that you've never done before. My reason why is passion.
My reason why is pride.
Coaches teach your kids to dream.
Coaches, teach your kids to overcome. Coaches, teach your kids good sportsmanship. Coaches, teach your kids proper technique. But who teaches your coaches?
National studies show that students who participate in activities like music, sports, and drama not only have better grades and attendance, but they develop the character to handle adversity, the grace to accept defeat, and the self-confidence to start over. Take part. Get set for life.
See ya, honey.
You wouldn't do this with your car. So why would you let it happen to your body? You've got too much to do to tolerate the aches and pains that could be treated easily and inexpensively. Registered physical therapists can get you back to work and play fast. In most cases, you don't need a doctor's referral, and treatment is covered by almost all insurance. Come in for a free consultation, and let's get you fully active again. Go to rptonline.com for more information.
Spot people who participated in high school sports and activities.
Right on time.
They learned important lessons like leadership, teamwork, respect.
Hey, our meeting moved to 10.
We'll be ready.
Values that last a lifetime.
We need to focus on three factors.
Support high school sports and activities in your community. When kids take part, they get set for life. Just a reminder, kids who participate in high school activities tend to go a little farther than those who don't. Take part. Get set for life.
Shakespeare said that all the world's a stage, and men and women are merely players.
But Mr. Shakespeare never met Stephen Curry.
Nihao, the guy who's in the gym every dang day. Patriots say I'm the underdog, the league's most unguardable player. Bang, he knocks it down. So my apologies to Mr. Shakespeare, because onto the stage of mere players enters the babyface assassin. And he's about to write his own story.
Fall back.
You know, the Greek philosopher Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. But in our book, we say you are what you repeatedly do when things get hard. When you look at the naysayers and the haters, and there's a million of them, but you take it upon yourself to erase all doubt. Get that doubt out of here. So my apologies to Aristotle, but excellence doesn't become a habit by running the same path over and over. The excellent ones just step up to the line and ask, what's the record? Under Armour, get your feet straight.
I want to encourage others to play volleyball or choir because you get to experience new things and do stuff that you've never done before. My reason why is passion.
Welcome back to the Utah High School Activities Association's presentation of the 2017 3A State Championships. Getting ready to get underway. Ball's kicked off, and Ridgeline has possession. Ball is headed out of bounds. Juan Diego tosses it in. Out of bounds, ruled Juan Diego's ball. Juan Diego again in the blue jerseys. Trying to score in the north goal, protecting the south goal. Ridgeline, Riverhawks. Juan Diego with the ball. Ridgeline takes it back. Foul called against Ridgeline. Juan Diego will have a free kick from the attacking side of the field. Look to see if they can score here. Headed out. Juan Diego still with possession, goes up high. Mariano working the far corner. He's going to have a shot to center it. Just missed by Ruben Castillo. Juan Diego again with possession. Shot is just wide, coming off the foot. I believe that's number 9, Christian Finney, or maybe 19, Jared Mariani. Yeah, it was 19, Jared Mariani, who had the kick. Out of bounds, Juan Diego's ball. Evan Carlisle will toss it in. Mariani. Mariani chips ahead to Castillo, goal! Ruben Castillo of Juan Diego. He's the state's leading goal scorer. Jared Mariani with the assist to Ruben Castillo, puts Juan Diego up 1-0 early in the second half. Ball's kick clear by Martin Kelly. Mariano looking to score. Ball goes off. Oh, that was off number 7, Christian Carabaja. That's a bad call, missed call. Seth Blazingham. Wow, another missed call. That's a really bad missed call. Ball's cleared away. Chipped ahead. Ball's kicked out, but Ridgeline maintains possession. JC Vasquez in the box. Corner kick to come, JC Vasquez. playing with a lot of energy as his team is now down 1-0. He's got to equalize. Here comes the service. Mariani in the open field. He's got to look for number 14. Seth Blazingham, shot on goal. Nicely defended by Joseph Enhaus. JC Vasquez, up ahead. Oh, offsides. Offsides for Kelton Zollinger. Cleared out by Martin Kelly. Zollinger now in the open field. Ruben Castillo steals it. Ahead to Mariano. Shot on goal, defended well by Joseph Venhaus. Both these teams are playing with a lot of energy right now. Across the field to Houston Gallagher. Zollinger ahead. He'll look to cross. A little bit of extracurricular activity. Official comes to make sure that it doesn't turn into a fight. Martin Kelly clears. Stolen away. Juan Diego has the ball. Working to counter. Sent far. Mariano again on the near side. Ruben. Oh, just off the crossbar. Good look from Ruben Castillo, the state's leading goal scorer. In is Sam Blad for the Riverhawks. Castillo kicks up ahead. Up ahead. Oh, a little too much maybe. And that's the case, too much for number four, Benson Hill, to chase down. Goal kick for Martin Kelly. JC Vasquez. A lot of speed. Ball's kicked out of bounds. Martin Kelly sends the ball away midfield. Ruben Castillo in the open field. Nice pass back to Castillo. Joseph Enhaus has been really good the last couple of minutes. It's been just him and a few up. JC Vasquez working this far side. Ridgeline's ball. Juan Diego to toss in on the far side. Out of bounds. Juan Diego again tossing in near midfield. Oh, shot is high. Off the foot of number 7, Christian Carabaja. Official has a word with Joseph Venhaus. Carabaja and Venhaus had a collision. And Venhaus maybe had a little extra push at the end. Up ahead, JC Vasquez. Ball's kicked out of bounds. Ridgeline's ball. Hunter Buchanan tosses the ball in. Number 25, Braden Reed checks into the game. It's Juan Diego. Tosses the ball in here on the near side. Ball is sent up. Seth Blazingham sends the ball in. Juan Diego's ball. Castillo boots it up high. Juan Diego with possession. Across to Ramona, who kicks it off of, I think that was number 11, Reggie Anderson. So corner kick coming. To be serviced by Alex Saunders. The NFHS Network would like to thank our corporate sponsors, Under Armour and Olive Garden, for their support to put your kids on the air. Foul called on Lynn. Free kick coming. Christian Finney to kick. Boots it into the goal box. Missed over the top. No, but they're saying they got a piece of it. So corner kick to come. Ball's cleared out. Oh, bad pass. Pass gets back to, ball gets back to Vasquez. Shot! Shot on goal is just a little high. Martin Kelly to send the ball away. Yellow card to be awarded to number 3 for Juan Diego. Ramona Kinururadi. He'll take a seat on the bench. Taiki Hayashi, number 6, checks in. Number 3, Houston Golliter checks in for Kelton Zollinger. Juan Diego wins possession. Very special thank you to the Utah High School Activity Association and its member schools for their support of the National Federation of State High School Associations and the NFHS Network. High kick coming in from Taki Hayashi. So free kick coming off the foot of Mario Saldivar. Mariani fighting for the ball. Corner kick to come. It's either Benson Hill or Luke Diamond back there. It might have even been Hunter Buchanan. Sorry, hard to say back here. A little numbers. Ball went out of bounds. checking in number 7, Christian Carabaja for the Juan Diego Eagles. Number 12, Andy Payne checks in for the Riverhawks. Vasquez has the ball. Number 7 shoots it long. Goal kick coming for Martin Kelly. More subs checking in. 25 and 4 for the Riverhawks. 25 we don't have on the roster here, but number 4 is Benson Hill. Ball sent across the field. Headers won by 12, Andy Payne. He's shoved down. And it's called, it's in the box. We got a penalty kick coming up. One from the efforts of Andy Payne. Evan Carlisle petitioning the official. No surprise that JC Vasquez is going to be taking this kick. Here comes. Score! JC Vasquez evens the match 1-1. On the penalty kick, JC Vasquez, the coach's son, evens the score 1-1. With 17:35 here to go in the second half of the match. Two strikers, as promised, JC Vasquez and the state's leader, Ruben Castillo, have each scored a goal for their team. Cleared out. Goes out of bounds. Possession still to Juan Diego. Alex Saunders. Alex Saunders whiffs ahead to JC Vasquez, who just scored. He's in the open field. Works away center. Up to Andy Payne, who earned that penalty kick for Vasquez. Back to Saldivar, who lost it on the pass to Vasquez. I believe that's Flores. Keeper Joseph Enhaus comes up. Mariani wins the ball. Kicks it right into the waiting hands of Joseph Enhaus. Sent ahead. Ball's grabbed by Martin Kelly. That was number three, Houston Gallagher on the move. Working his way to the center of the field, and Ridgeline has possession. They were down 1-0. Just even the score on a penalty kick. JC Vasquez looks to Payne. Payne shot and misses. Ball's cleared out. Vasquez is tackled. Zollinger and Lillian are checking in. Lillian for Juan Diego and Zollinger for Ridgeline. Number nine, Mario Saldivar to service the corner kick. Comes the ball, it's good placement. Nicely grabbed though by Martin Kelly. Ball won back by Ridgeline in the open field. Martin Kelly comes up and scoops it up. Collision stops the match. Ruben Castillo collided and was on the ground for a little bit. It'll be Ridgeline's ball. They'll get a free kick. Ball sent into the box. Grabbed by Martin Kelly. Ball ends out of bounds. Ridgeline's ball. The Riverhawks down 1-0. Looking to even the match. Mariano up ahead, but Joseph Van Haas works his way to the front of the goalie box to grab that ball. Ball's cleared out. Mario Saldivar will toss the ball in. Gives that duty up to Hunter Buchanan. JC Vasquez. That goes off the foot of Juan Diego's Christian Carabaja. Hunter Buchanan tosses up ahead to Benson Hill. Goal kick. Martin Kelly. Ruben Castillo has the ball. He hasn't been as active. Haven't seen him touching the ball a lot since that score on the penalty kick from JC Vasquez. Up the field goes Ridgeline. Vasquez. Another big boot from number seven. Sorry that we don't have his name on our roster that we were given. He wins that ball. penalty on Seth Blasingham. A little bit of frustration coming from Blasingham. Salvador boots it up ahead to Vasquez. And smart move from the junior, Martin Kelly, who sends the ball out of bounds. Saldivar gets possession. Back to Buchanan. Number 7 to Buchanan. Buchanan with the ball. Up ahead to Vasquez. To Payne. Nice work from number 9. That's Christian Finney, the defender. He gets fouled. Number 4, Mark Martinez, boots that deep. Payne whiffs. Saldivar has possession, passes it to number 7. Back to Vasquez, loses it. Lillian up to Mariani. Out of bounds. Ridgeline's ball. There's 8 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the match. It's been all Ridgeline ever since that penalty kick, even the score. Lillian passes ahead to Armani. Lillian, shot, headed away. Sub in. Number 12, Andy Payne checks out. Number 25 checks in. He's another person we don't have on our roster. Hunter Buchanan chases the ball down. JC Vasquez. That seemed like a missed call. I'm pretty sure it went off Vasquez. Benson. The official couldn't make up his mind who had the ball. Gave it to Ridgeline. He's going to stay with that. Sent. Headed too high by JC Vasquez. Martin Kelly to send away. We're at 6 minutes to go in the match. And we're still tied 1-1. Carlisle clears it out. Hit by Zollinger, out of bounds. Ball's thrown back into play. Number 7 number four for Ridgeline in the open field. Hit out of bounds. That was Benson Hill pushing up the field. Similar spot as the last throw-in on the near side. Serviced in. Alex Saunders is looking to check in. There's a foul of that kick. Hit some other players. Martin Kelly fields that ball. Benson Hill passes to Vasquez. Mario Saldivar, number seven. Up to Houston. Gallagher in the corner. Sent too far. It's going to be Juan Diego's ball on the far side of the field near their own net. Alex Saunders checks in for Matthew Lillian. Or Lillian. Lillian. Number seven for Ridgeline possesses the ball. Vasquez passes up to Zollinger. On the offensive, headed out. Nice defense. Seems like Ridgeline has had possession almost the entire time since their penalty kick. Vasquez making people miss. Shot on goal. Oh, is just wide. A good shot on goal from Vasquez with 3 minutes to go in the match. I want to let you know you can use your mobile device to log on and watch your favorite high school sporting events wherever you are, whenever you want. Never miss another game. Two and a half minutes from the end of the match and overtime if there's not a goal scored. Cleared away. JC Vasquez has the ball. Loses it, Alex Saunders of Juan Diego passes ahead, out of bounds. Tossed in, Carlisle kicks it back. Zollinger, penalty called. Two minutes to go. Mario Saldivar kicks it in. Fielded by Martin Kelly. Evan Carlisle up the field. Zollinger steals it away. Up ahead to Mariani. He's been resting. He's got fresh legs. Hasn't been doing a lot back there. Crossed over. Who else would you want to take it? Castillo. Nice defense, though. Ruben Castillo looking to score one more goal this year. Sent out of bounds. Off the leg of Buchanan. Seth Blazingham. Forty seconds to go in the match. Mariani crosses. Headed out. K Kicked up high. We'll see who wins possession. Saldivar. Foul called with 10 seconds. Two, one. That's the end of regulation. We're headed to overtime. As I understand the overtime rules, we're going to have a 10-minute period, and it'll be sudden death, so first team to score in that period will be your state champions. We'll wait to hear officially what'll happen. We want to let you know, folks, the NFHS Network School Broadcast Program makes it easy for students to produce live video broadcasts by providing the software, tools, and training they need for free. Now students can produce and distribute high-quality events throughout the year, including regular season sports, graduation, band, cheer events, as well as other school activities. If your school is interested in becoming a part of the NFHS Network School Broadcast Program, please write to sbp@nfhsnetwork.com. That's sbp@nfhsnetwork.com. nfhsnetwork.com, we are high school. So the coaches have an opportunity to chat with their players. We're a minute and 15 seconds away. Once again, overtime is a 10-minute period. First team to score wins. If that overtime period ends and no one has scored, we'll do one more 10-minute overtime period. If no one scored after 20 minutes of extra play, then we'll move to penalty kicks to decide. Part of me hopes for penalty kicks so we can just see some more good soccer. We also know that lots of soccer players don't feel that that's the best way to end the match. They want to win it the way that the game is usually played. It's been great so far. As advertised, JC Vasquez, son of the coach, senior forward, he scored, as well as the state's leading scorer in all classifications, Ruben Castillo. Ridgeline will be in the south end of the field, Juan Diego in the north. Ridgeline will start with the ball. JC Vasquez. We're underway, up ahead, and ball goes out of bounds. Goal kick to come for Martin Kelly and Juan Diego. Martin Kelly boots it away. Ridgeline advancing. Juan Diego looking to counter now. Foul against Vasquez. Earned by number 3, Ramione Tinerati. Evan Carlisle to boot this ball for the Eagles. Sends it away. Header won by Zollinger. Ridgeline's looked like a different team ever since they knotted the score even. Much more aggressive. Ridgeline now running across the field is number 3. He passes it back to J.C. Vasquez. It's going to be sent out of bounds. Ridgeline will be able to toss it in. That was Houston Gallagher running up the field. Toss center. Cleared out. Zollinger kicks it hard. Again blocked. Carlisle sends it clear. Zollinger all over the field right now. Mariana in the open field. Mario Saldivar back to number 7. He hits it up to J.C. Vasquez. Zollinger. Tripped Anderson. Kicks it out of bounds. Ruben Castillo falls to the ground and grabs his ankle. Mariana. It's getting extra out there. Benson Hill. Up ahead. Say there's a lot of physicality in this overtime period. Saldivar. Vasquez. Back to Vasquez. Sent away. Number 7 to toss in. Headed out. Zollinger wins it though. Up ahead to Castillo is on the move in the open field. Joseph Venhaas picks it up. Juan Diego wins possession. Benson Hill. J.C. Vasquez. Alex Saunders looking Mariano. Mariano's going to have an opportunity here. Crosses it to Joseph Venhaas, who catches it. Fields it cleanly. 5 minutes to go. We're halfway through this overtime, this first overtime period. Saunders chips ahead. Foul wanted there as Castillo hits the ground. Benson Hill passes, intercepted. Shot comes on goal. Joseph Enhaus there calmly to collect it. Four minutes to go. Venhaus sends it midfield. Vasquez possesses it. Christian Finney sent that ball out of bounds. Houston Gallagher tosses up number seven. Number seven for Juan Diego. Kicks it back. Saunders up to Mariana. It's a foot race. Too much sauce on that one. Ridgeline's ball. Pass it in. That one's headed back out of bounds. Number seven, Christian Carabaja. Checks out. Number five, Matthew Lillian, checks in. Saunders with the ball, fighting. Nice screen by the official, unintentional. Sub in Andy Payne, comes in for Benson Hill. Two and a half minutes to go. Joseph Venhaus didn't quite get all of that. Back to Zollinger, up to Saldivar, to Houston Gallagher. Saldivar. Mishandled. Romani. Zollinger kicks it away. Payne on the far side. Nice tackle from number 14, Seth Blazingham. Blazingham blazing up the field. He collides. Ball goes out of bounds. Minute and a half to go in the first overtime period. If no score here, we'll do 10 more minutes of the same. Juan Diego's ball. Juan Diego's ball again. Payne misses. Lillian gets it. Lillian again. Looking up to Rami. Up to Castillo. Shot on goal! Wow! Great look for Ruben Castillo. There's only 40 seconds. They stop the clock for an injured player up top. Official is not set. Number seven checks into the game, Christian Carabaja. 40 seconds to go in the match, the state 3A finals. Ball's headed out. Juan Diego with possession. Evan Carlisle. Mariani. Foul called against Mariani. There's just 10 seconds to go. That's the end of the first overtime period. They'll end up switching sides, I believe. Ridgeline started with the ball, so Juan Diego will get the start with the ball this second overtime period. Again, it is a sudden death overtime. So first team to score will win. This next 10 minutes ends without a score. We'll go to penalty kicks. Ridgeline's crowd, Juan Diego's crowd, getting into it. This is what these players play for. It's what they practice for all season in anticipation for this, the state championship game. Ridgeline Riverhawks playing Juan Diego Catholic Soaring Eagles. It's 1-1. Second overtime period is underway. Picked up by Joseph Van Haas. Boots it past midfield. Kicked out of bounds by Juan Diego's Mark Martinez, JC Vasquez will give up the duties to number 7. Wish we had that player's name. He's had a great game. Lots of good passes. Strong man tossing the ball in. Shot goes high off the foot of Benson Hill. Goal kick for Martin Kelly. Header goes out of bounds. It's off Hunter Buchanan. Seth Blazingham of the Juan Diego Eagles to toss the ball in. He finds Alex Saunders. Headed away, Alex Saunders hits it again. Heads up play by Joseph Van Haas. Not sure if Reggie Anderson saw Ruben Castillo closing in. Hunter Buchanan, the nifty move. Taken away by Mariani, up to Saunders, up to Lillian. Shot goes wide left. Joseph Enhas to send this goal kick away. Alex Saunders wins the header. Sent clear. Mariano up to head to Castillo. Caught by Joseph Enhas. Kicker boots it deep. Keeper boots it deep. Carlisle tosses. Buchanan steals it back. Mariani and Carlisle, or Mariani and Buchanan fighting. Mariani in the open field. He's going to have a shot. Oh, wide right. Ruben Castillo. It's off his foot. Close calls. Buchanan fighting for it. Off the foot of Mariani. Kick clear. Sam Payne chasing down the keeper. Martin Kelly making sure that he's honest about that. Lillian to Castillo to Saunders. Zollinger kicks it clear. 5 minutes to go and Juan Diego's on the attack. Carlisle to Ramey. Carlisle back to Lillian. Centered. Headed out. JC Vasquez now has ball. Remains Ridgeline's ball. Zollinger to toss it in instead. 4.5 minutes to go in this second overtime period. Taken by Lillian. Buchanan sends it out. Seth Blasingham tosses it in to Mariani, to Christian Calabarja, to Alex Saunders, to Mariani. Castillo. Nice defensive work. JC Vasquez has it. He's looking for Payne. Payne's got it. Cleared away by Martinez. Back to Lillian. Ridgeline's ball. 3.5 minutes to go. Checking in for the Riverhawks. TJ Benson checks in for number 9, Mario Saldivar. Down at the far end is JC Vasquez. He's going to have a corner kick here. 3 minutes to go. Second overtime. Ridgeline brings many players front. Seven. Give so much extra effort throughout the game. Oh, we really wish we had that kid's name on the roster. Great goal. Your state champions are the Ridgeline Riverhawks. These overtime periods have been brought to you by Olive Garden. Thank them for our sponsors that we could put this on the air. Your 3A state champions. It took them 18 minutes of overtime to make it happen. But your champions were the Ridgeline Riverhawks. Thank you for joining us on the NFHS Network's broadcast of the Utah High School Activity Association's 3A Soccer Championship.
Olive Garden delivers the final moments. Bring home Italian favorites and they'll cheer for you on game day. Olive Garden is the official dining room of high school sports, and with the new catering delivery service, you never have to miss a moment.
Thanks again. Congratulations to the Ridgeline Riverhawks winning in overtime. For everyone at NFHS Networks and the Utah High School Activity Association, I'm David Boyle.